Hi, everybody. Welcome to our community education video. Today, we're talking about the role of a nurse practitioner. And joining me is Julia Brandenburg, who's a nurse practitioner for Chesapeake Supportive Care. So thanks, Julia, for taking some time. We started talking. You've already been on the phone. I know it's a really busy time for you. So
sure. Thanks. My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for talking. I think the first place to start is let's review a few terms because I think that gets kind of confusing. Supportive care, palliative care, hospice. How, if you can just give me a brief sort of how they all play together, what they mean.
Sure. So supportive care is the same exact thing as palliative care. It's a national drive, if you will, to change the name of the companies to supportive care because so many people thought palliative care was synonymous with hospice and were apprehensive of accepting of the services. So, and what we do is support, a lot of support, as well as, treat symptoms and everything else that's involved. So supportive care and palliative care are synonymous, and they deal with treating and managing symptoms related to diseases such as pain, nausea, vomiting, shortness of breath, or symptoms related to treatments for chronic illness or life-limiting illness as a patient goes through their treatment process. Hospice is specifically when a patient has chosen to no longer seek treatment for a chronic illness or a life-limiting illness, or if unfortunately their disease process has progressed to the point of where they, if the disease were to continue along its same trajectory, that they would pass within an estimated 6 months time period. So that is truly the difference between palliative and supportive care, which are synonymous, and hospice.
Okay. What, and I'm sure you deal with this all the time in your role, what are some of the biggest misconceptions that you come across that people are just sort of like, oh, I just didn't understand that that's what that was?
Right. So as I mentioned before, that people equate palliative care with hospice. They're not the same thing. That's one. The second one would be that when we mention hospice to patients and to family members, their first thought seems to be they think it's someplace where they go automatically. And so we do a lot of education about hospice happens wherever the patient lives, and more patients receive hospice services at home or wherever their home might be, assisted living, long-term care facility, in the hospitals, if it becomes an acute short-term necessity, it can be done in the hospital as well.
So people, instead of understanding that hospice is a type of care, they equate it with a actual place to go to. So kind
exactly.
of understanding yes. that it's the care, not the location.
Right.
All right.
Yeah. So those are probably the two biggest misconceptions that we deal with all the time.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
What as your role as a nurse practitioner, what's the difference between that and a physician or some of the other members on the supportive care team? Like what do you do in essence?
So the supportive care team, first of all, entails it's a nurse practitioner or a physician. We have social workers who visit with patients and involved in the care. And we have chaplains also who, if that is something that a patient is interested in, can be involved in the care and visit with the patients as well. The difference between the role of a nurse practitioner and a physician in regard to palliative care, there is no difference. Nurse practitioners in the state of Maryland work independently, so we provide as if basically, if the patient wants, we work as part of their team. We'll work with their primary care provider or whomever their specialists are. We have some patients that are homebound who prefer to have us also manage their primary care. So we will do that as well. We prescribe, we, you know, treat as if a primary care provider with specializing in symptom management, whatever their symptoms might be.
I'm going to jump in for a second because I just want to clarify. When you say someone is homebound and you're providing care, so that means you're going into their home to
yes.
see them. Okay. Yes. All right. I just want to make sure that I'm clear on that.
Yeah. So palliative care is provided in different scenarios. As we stated, it's provided in the community wherever the patient lives. It's also provided in the hospital. The provision of care and what you do is a little bit different. At those different levels, community-based is more as I was describing, where, you know, manage the symptoms a little bit for longer periods of time. And provide for the homebound patients, we can provide primary care as well if that is something that they are interested in, and the team together decides that is what's best for them.
Okay.
On the hospice side, the team does consist similarly as with the palliative supportive team, but with the hospice side, there is also available, there's volunteers who can come in and spend time with the patients and the family. There is also the family life services. So there's counseling, grief counseling available. We do reach out to the counselors at times for our palliative patients if we feel that it's necessary. So that is also available to them. We just typically don't use it as often. On the hospice side, the main difference is, and it's driven by Medicare at this point, it's called certificate of terminal illness has to be done by a physician. So once that's done and the patient is qualified for hospice, then a nurse practitioner or a physician can then continue to see the patient. We do things that are called face-to-faces, where we just go and assess the patient on, you know, how they're feeling on certain time periods and order medications. And at that point we do similar things.
So going into just a little bit, just to dig a little deeper with your inpatient or your visits that you're going in someone's home for those folks that are homebound, when you're providing the supportive care piece, and I'm assuming hospice care piece too, but definitely for supportive care, about how much time for you as a nurse practitioner are you spending with that patient?
So typically if it's a first visit, it's easily 2 hours with the patient and their family. And subsequent visits after that are at least an hour. They typically end up being about an hour and a half. All situational. A lot of what we do in palliative medicine is a psychosocial support, and so the visit lends itself to having the time and really, you know, giving the patient and the family the time that they need and deserve.
So to clarify, psychosocial, you're talking more than just the medical piece. You're talking about,
Right. Okay,
what's happening with their family, you know, how things, okay. So it covers a little bit broader than just, you know, here's your blood pressure for today and how much.
Yeah, exactly. So we treat, in palliative medicine, supportive medicine, we treat the whole person. So we don't just look at their illness and treat the illness specifically. We, as I stated, I say treat the whole person. We want to know, you know, do they have specific cultural beliefs? Do they have specific religious beliefs that all will tie into how they choose their goals of care and how they want to, you know, approach their management of their disease. And so, you know, we take the time, it's more of a holistic type of medicine, provision than just like a specialist, a cardiologist who focuses on the one organ.
Right. Just who's looking at just their heart, and how you're looking at every aspect of them as an individual and how that all plays together. Yeah. I think
absolutely.
That's so key to bring up. So I know you've been doing this a while, and I'm guessing there's probably someone's journey or someone's story, a patient that you've had that's had sort of an impact or left an impression on you. Would you be able to share that with us?
Sure. Fortunately, I've done community-based and hospital-based, which is what I do now. But I think the community-based patients, although the hospital-based patients do too, leave a big impact on us as well as we with them and their family. Because we do, it's such a newer branch of medicine, and even allowing patients to choose their own path and make their decisions on how they receive their care or whether they don't receive care is so new that I think when we educate them as to what is available to them and it's their choice and help them understand fully their disease process and expected trajectories and the benefits and burdens of treatments, when they come to this realization, we've had a number of patients in the community I have where we manage symptoms and help them have a better quality of life as they would go through their treatments. And when they feel it's too much of a burden, that we are a sounding board for them. And so they feel very comfortable talking to us about it. A lot of times they will talk to us, and then we meet with their family and we help them share this with their family and make the decision to where, let's say it was a cancer patient, that the treatments that they're receiving are just too burdensome for them and their quality of life is not what they want. So we help them talk to their family about that and make the decision to transfer to hospice at that point, and just have the continuum of care and be very comfortable and help everybody accept it, which is not easy. So
that's where I would think the 2-hour, 1-hour conversations come into play. Like, you can't have that conversation in a 15-minute appointment.
No, right. Right.
And the other team members, the chaplain or the social worker, like those roles kind of all help support that. Yeah. Yes. I love how you're saying that as far as empowering a person to really understand what their options are, because I think a lot of times people don't really, there's a lot of medical language and terminology, and that's hard to break down and absorb. And to have someone like yourself, who's a medical professional, to sit down and take the time to really, okay, here, if you get this treatment, here's what it looks like for the for your journey, right? Like, and here we are, we'll be with you every step of the way.
Absolutely. And I say that to patients and family all the time. Like, we are here to support you in your choices and your goals. That is our goal, is your goal. And we will make sure that you understand the benefits, the burdens of all of it, and how it can possibly affect you. So that's the big part. And they're extremely thankful for that.
Then on the added side of that, you're helping communicate that to their family, because those are hard conversations. I can only imagine, like, that's the person who's going through the illness may have a very strong feeling about that, but then their family members, loved ones might have different opinions, and to sort of advocate.
Exactly. And a lot of times too, patients feel guilty when they have to tell their provider who's managing that illness for them that they've chosen not to continue down a certain path of treatment. And so we actually support them in that. We will make those phone calls for them and have those conversations with those other providers if they choose. Again, we're there just to support them, but we find that that's a situation that some of the patients are into. So we, you know, we help them get across that as well.
And I'm thinking too, probably on the opposite side of that, if someone is interested in getting additional treatment, your role could be to help them understand, to communicate with the physician, what does that actually mean? Just right. From a, you know, nurse practitioner or physician to physician, like getting all that information so that they can make an informed.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's a big part of what we do.
That's awesome. Well, Julia, thank you so much for taking a little bit of time this morning. And I just think what you do is so important and helps so many people. And I appreciate your time.
Sure. Well, thanks for having me.
Have a good day. Also thank the John and Kathy Belcher Institute for their generous support of the community education programs here at Hospice of the Chesapeake. Thanks.
Absolutely. Thanks. Bye.